The production of a piece of porcelain in the 18th century was a very long and very complex process, which would involve the work of many skilled hands. From the creation of the paste, the shape, and sculptural details, to the painting, gilding, and multiple firing of the object. But first of all, it would also require a designer, someone who had an initial idea or a vision of what the piece should look like. Jean-Claude Chambellan Duplessis was Sèvres' chief designer during the 1750s and 60s, and he created models for the manufactory that were of hitherto unprecedented technical and stylistic sophistication and would set new standards for porcelain production in Europe. Here at the Wallace collection, we have one of the most important collections of Sèvres vases designed by Duplessis. The vases were the manufactory's most elaborate range and really show the full scope of his creative ingenuity. This model we see here was called a vase urne antique. Duplessis designed it in 1756, which was a time when generally criticism against the Rococo style with its exuberant curves and this very playful extravagance was growing, and antique art became a more and more important reference. But although this urne antique was given a classical reference, details like the scroll-footed stand and the scalloped and pierced handles clearly make it a creation of the Rococo. A prime example of the French Rococo's exuberance is this exceptional model, the vase à tête d'éléphant, where we can see Duplessis actually took up the very simple and sleek outlines of the vase urne antique we saw earlier, but here he added a very extravagant sculptural decoration. The elephant's heads are supporting scrolled candle holders, underneath we've got the beading, and again the scroll-footed stand that we also find in the vase urne antique. Now the eye for detail here is really extraordinary. We've got the creased trunk, we've got the ears rendered in greatest detail, we've got the eyes with the eyelashes and eyebrows, and we can assume that the direct reference for describing the elephant's physiognomy in this great detail might have actually been a rather unusual source, a written post-mortem of an actual elephant that was owned by Louis XIV. This wonderful gondola here was actually a potpourri vase, which would have been filled with all sorts of perfume, flowers and spices, anything that would make your room smell nicely. This is why we have this very elaborate piercing, which is rendered in a very decorative way. But also very fittingly, we can see that the function of the object is reflected in its decoration. On the lid, we've got all sorts of sculptural flowers, tulips, carnations, and roses. So the decoration actually really hints at the use of the object. Duplessis' designs were very typical creations of the Rococo in a way, because as you can see, they are full of playfulness, full of wit and fantasy. And at the same time, they really demonstrate the high level of craftsmanship which the French artisans had managed to acquire at that point. These vases really became highly sought after luxury items that were very popular throughout the 18th and 19th century, not only in France, but also in England, which is why we are lucky enough at the Wallace Collection to have this wonderful selection of vases designed by Duplessis.